conscience and energy. Consciousness and energy and excerpt from the license beyond imprint. An excerpt from the license beyond imprint. Matter is energy, and energy cannot be destroyed. Only the form of energy changes. And this you have to remember always. Only the form of energy changes from gross to subtle. When we look at the body, it is gross. Mind, the energies of the mind are subtle. And energies cannot be destroyed. Sound is energy, and the sound waves cannot be destroyed. It gets so intense that sometimes it becomes very difficult to decide. But we need special instruments to decipher the sound waves. I am speaking, sound waves are created. These are analog waves. The device of the telephone, my receiver of the telephone, converts the analog waves, sound waves, into digital sound waves. And digital sound waves travel beyond time and space and can remain there easily accessible for some time. Thereafter, these become more subtle. Whatever I am speaking, the audio sound, the sound waves, the sound energy is converted into analog as I speak. This is analog. And then when it is converted through the device of Skype, through the device of telephone, it is changed into digital format, and then it becomes easy to travel. And when the same sound waves reach your receiver, then again the digital waves are converted into analog waves, and only then you can hear. Digital waves we cannot hear, digital sound waves, unless they are converted into analog once again. This is the process. Modern physics has discovered one of the greatest things ever, and that is, this is the contribution of Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein's contribution to humanity, E is equal to mc square. E represents energy. Matter only appears. And there is no such thing as matter, nothing is solid. Even the solid rock is a pulsating energy. Even the solid rock is as much fluid like energy as the rolling ocean. We think we find the ocean is fluid energy, but the rock is no. Rock is as fluid as the ocean energy. The waves that are arising in the solid rock, they cannot be seen because they are very subtle. The waves arising on the surface of the ocean are gods, and that's why they can be visible. But the rock too is beating, pulsating, breathing, and it is alive. However, movement is so subtle that mind never captured it. Friedrich Nietzsche has declared that God is dead. He is mistaken. God is not dead, on the contrary, matter is no more. Matter is dead. And the more precise the matter is, and more precisely, matter is not dead either. Something dies only if it exists as matter. Matter has not been found, matter has been found not to exist at all. Matter does not exist at all. This insight into matter brings modern physics very close to mysticism. For the first time, the scientists and mystics are coming very close to one another. For the first time, the scientists and the mystics are coming very close to one another. Mystics have always maintained that consciousness is. Man exists as consciousness, and this consciousness is his energy. Man is nothing but ever-expanding consciousness. Such is the understanding of sages and mystics over the period of time. Eddington, Sir Arthur Henry Eddington, a British astrophysicist of the 20th century, discovered the Eddington limit, the natural limit to the luminosity of stars or the radiation generated by accretion onto a compact object. And this is named in his honor. He is famous for his work regarding the theory of relativity, which he explained to the British speaking world. He also conducted an expedition to observe the solar eclipse of famous 29th of May 1919. And that provided one of the earliest confirmations of relativity, and became known for its popular expositions and interpretations of the theory. It is said that the theory of relativity of Einstein is very difficult for people to comprehend. Only few people are there in the world who can understand the theory of relativity. Eddington said, we used to think that matter is a thing. Now it is no more so. Matter is more like a thought than a thing. Entire existence is energy. Science has discovered that the observed is energy. Whatever is observed is energy. The object is energy. At least for 5,000 years, this has been known, that the other polarity is the subject. The observer or consciousness is energy. The subject, the observer or consciousness is energy. Indeed, consciousness is energy. Energy is fluid-like. That is why it goes on expanding. It is dynamic and constantly moving. Your body is energy, your mind is energy, and your soul too is energy. Then what is the difference between the body, the mind, and the soul? The difference is only of a different rhythm. different wavelengths. When you look at the radio, certain colors are visible from a distance while others are not. It is because of the wavelength of the colors. When we look at the rainbow, the colors red, violet, indigo, blue, and all these colors, each color represents a wavelength. The red color is visible from a far distance. The green color's wavelength is the smallest. That's why this color is not visible from a distance, a far distance. This is why the traffic signals have been used using the three lights, red, yellow, and green. Red is visible from a distance, and that's why red has been used to stop. So in the same way, the wavelengths of the body, mind, and soul differ. The body is lost through body energy, through body energy functions in a gross way, and as a result it is visible. We can see the body. Certainly the body mind is relatively more subtle, but is still not too subtle. You can close your eyes and you can see thoughts moving. Thoughts arising from the human screen. Thoughts can be seen. They are not as visible as body. This we have to understand. Our eyes can easily envision that which is the process. The moment the subtlety comes, the eyes cannot envision it. Thoughts can be seen, but they are not as visible as your body. Your body is visible to everybody else. Human body is publicly visible. Your thoughts are private and remains visible to you alone. Nobody else can see your thoughts. This is the nature of subtlety of thoughts. Only you can see them, or people who have worked very deeply into seeing thoughts, they can see your thoughts. But ordinarily, they are not visible to others. And the third, the ultimate layer deep within you is that of consciousness. It is not even visible to you. It cannot be reduced to an object. It remains the subject of your subjectivity. But all these three layers of energy function in harmony with one another, you are healthy and whole. If these energies do not function in harmony and accord, you are ill, unhealthy, and you are no more whole, and to be whole is wholeness. This is the first criteria, and the most essential criteria of male-female relation. Unless these three layers work in harmony with one another, you cannot attain to blissfulness out of male-female relation. Because body operates at the level of the lust, which is gross, and the mind is subtle, it operates at the level of the love. Nobody knows what thoughts are going on in your mind when you are making love. This is subtle, and yet still beyond this there is your subjectivity, which is subtlest and is not visible to anyone, not even to you. As a master, my effort is to discover ways and means to help you so that body, mind, and consciousness all can dance in one rhythm. in togetherness and in deep harmony, not in any conflict, instead in deep cooperation with one another. The lust must support the love and love must support the lust. Together, the harmony of the two will open the door for the next step. The operation at the level of the body should not be mechanical. Just like your pressure over, when the pressure becomes unbearable within, the body releases the pressure and the pressure inside is released. Our interaction at the body level, at the level of lust, is like releasing the pressure wall, releasing the pressure from within through the pressure wall. The moment your body, mind and consciousness functions together in harmony with one another, you have become the Trinity. That experience of Trinity is God. The experience of that Trinity is God. There is no relationship between consciousness and energy. Instead, because consciousness is energy, so how can there be relation? Because both are the same thing. The purest energy. Mind is not so pure, and body is even less pure. Body can be considered as the gross because it is the impure. Mind is in between, it is subtle, and it is pure, but purity is still not too much. Body is much too mixed, and mind is also not totally pure. Consciousness is totally pure energy. But you can know this consciousness only if you make a cosmos out of three, and not a chaos. Mind is chaos, and meditation brings cosmos. Cosmos means harmony between all the existing constituents. People are living in chaos and inner conflict. Their bodies say one thing and want to go in one direction. Minds are completely oblivious of the body energies. For centuries you have been taught that you are not the body. Body is your enemy. You are taught that you have to fight with it and destroy it because body is sin. Whatsoever happens, it happens through the instrument of the body. When Adam sinned, as it is propagated by Christianity, by picking up the apple from the tree of the in the Garden of Eden, the forbidden tree, first the thought came, a desire came, then the mind cannot act. Mind acts only through the instruments of the body. Mind only operates through the instrument of the body. The feet walked, carried Adam to that forbidden tree. Then he used his hands, maybe he may have to tiptoe to reach the height of the apple. Then he used his hands to pick up fruit from the tree of Garden of Eden. Then he used his mouth to consume that fruit. So body is the instrument that operates at the command of the mind. still it is not operating at the command of the ego, the soul. Because there is no connectivity between the three. The moment there is cosmos, the three are pulsating in one rhythm, one harmony with one another. There is no more chaos. Body is following the command of the being via the instrument of the mind. The three are functioning, the three layers. People are living in chaos and inner conflict. Their bodies say one thing and wants to go in that direction. Minds are completely oblivious of the body. For centuries you have been taught that you are not the body. Body is your enemy. You are taught that you have to fight with the body and destroy it, because body is the sin. But you remember, body is the temple. If you destroy the temple walls, there will you enshrine the spirit. Body is the temple wherein is enshrined the spirit. But there are religious sects like Christianity and Raj Yoga. They destroy. They reject the body because body commits the sin. And the greatest sin that is considered is sex. Because we have not been able to understand the very energy. So that which we have not understood, we consider as sin. And admonish people to keep away from that. Such things are harmful and poisonous, but these have been taught for so long that they have become part of your collective mind. Such conditioning is there, and as a result you do not experience your body in a rhythmic dance with consciousness that you are. I emphasize, because of these conditions and as a result you do not experience your body in a rhythmic dance with consciousness that you are. I emphasize on dancing, music, song and celebration, because it is only in dance that you feel your body. When Jalaluddin Rumi danced for 35 hours, he experienced his body. And in that experiencing the body, he experienced that which is immovable within the body, that which does not change and around which all the change takes. This is what whirling means. This is what dance leads to. I emphasize on dancing, music, song and celebration, because it is only in dance that you will feel that your body, your mind and you are functioning together. This is what Sufi whirling is. Rumi danced for 36 hours. The body was whirling, but he became aware of the unmoving or the subtle movement of the consciousness. And this is what enlightenment is. You are aware of the subtle movements of consciousness within you. That it is the consciousness that is moving within, and because of that, the cross begins to move. and in that state you may attain to enlightenment. And the joy is infinite when all these functions together and the richness is created. This is the function of male-female relation. This is the way the male-female relation need to be. The body, the mind, and spirit working in harmony with one another. When two people who have attained the cosmos are working in harmony with one another, when they interact, the joy multiplies. And that is the greatest blessing. Consciousness is the highest form of energy. And when all these three energies function together, the fourth happens. The fourth is always present when these three function together. When these function as an organic unity, the fourth is always there, is still invisible but functioning. The fourth dimension is nothing else but that of organic unity. Organic means that which evolves as a functioning of others. The functioning of the three layers, when they are functioning in harmony with one another, this harmony is called the organic harmony. Out of that, the fourth is born. And fourth dimension is nothing but the organic unity. In the East, we have called that fourth simply the fourth of Turiya. Turiya is transcendent. We have not given it any name. The three have names, the fourth is nameless. Even Gurdjieff has not given it a name. He called it fourth name. To know the fourth is to know God. More precisely, God is when you are an organic, orgasmic unity. This is what male-female relation leads to. This is what sex leads to. More precisely to godliness. Sex in its ultimate state leads to organic, orgasmic unity. Sex leads to in its ultimate state to an organic, orgasmic unity, and this is the explosion into enlightenment. God is not when you are chaos, disunity or conflict. When you are a house divided against yourself, you are not God. When you are tremendously happy with yourself, happy as you are, blissful as you are, grateful as you are, and all your energies are dancing together, and you are an orchestra, or synergism, of all energies, for its fulfillment is, totality is, organic, organic is, enlightenment. That feeling of total unity or synergistic harmony is God. God is not a person somewhere, instead God is the experience of these three falling in such harmony, such unity, such blessedness that fourth arises. And the fourth is more than the aggregate of the parts. It is not that the sum total of the three is four. Fourth is transcendence. It is a growth beyond the tree. If you dissect a flower, you will find all the chemicals, the petal system and all. Maybe you can even separate the color and the fragrance too. But the flower will not be here. Remember the colors, flower, the petals, the fragrance is not the flower, or its aliveness. Even the aggregate of this is not the flower. You can dissect them and put them together, but the flower will not be there. Flower is something more, and that something more is expressed through the flower, color, beauty, fragrance, and aliveness that surrounds the flower. This is the fourth dimension. It is not aggregate of forms. It is a transcendence, it is a totality, it is beyond this. The whole is more than the sum total of the parts. It expresses through the parts, but it is more. To understand that it is more is to understand more. What is that more plus that? God is that more, that plus. It is not a question of theology. It cannot be decided by logical argumentation that God is. You have to feel the beauty, the music, the dance, the fragrance. Fragrance of your body, the dance, the movement of your body, the fragrance of your mind, the subtle movements of your mind, and the fragrance of your being. Then you can feel these in harmony with God, like a musical note, like the sonnet of a Beethoven. Only then you will be able to feel the presence of God. Why is a simultaneously meditation class goes on? When I meditate, I do my discourse thought. The dogs invite their friends and continue their discourse as well. We have to respect them for that. And ultimately you have to feel the dance in your body, mind and soul. You have to learn how to play on these three energies, on these three instruments simultaneously, so that the earth can become one orchestra. Then God is. Not that you see God. There is nothing to be seen. God is the ultimate seer, so how can you see? This is witness. Learn to melt your body, mind and soul into one melting pot. Find out ways and means when you can function as a unity. Dance is one of the most beautiful parts. Music, to dissolve in music, it's another aspect. To dissolve in the rhythm of the body through the male-female relation is another potent matter to dissolve in oneness. Two energies pulsating at the same wave level. Two harmonized energies pulsating in at the same wave level is the ultimate, is the fruition in sex, is fruition in male-female relation. You have to learn how to play on these three energies. It happens many times to runners. You will not think of running as a meditation, but runners sometimes have experienced a state of meditation. They were surprised because they were not looking for it. Who thinks that a runner is going to experience God? Certainly it has happened. And now running is becoming more and more like a kind of meditation. The harmony between body, mind and soul can happen in any act. Running, playing music, listening to the music, making love, or in any act, a runner, enjoy running in the early morning when the air is fresh and young. Enjoy running and the whole world is awakening out of sleep. Enjoy running as your body begins to function beautifully and it's the fresh air and everything is singing all around. Enjoy running when you are feeling so alive and pulsating with life force. This is the time when you enter into an end. A moment comes when the runner disappears. There is only running. The body, mind and soul starts functioning together. And suddenly an inner orgasm is released. You have attained the fruition of the merger of three energies. When your body, mind and being are dancing in one common, that is the time to enter into a male female relation. The joy will be tremendous. Transcendence will happen. Runners have sometimes come accidentally on the experience of the fourth dimension. Although they will miss because they will think it was just because of running that they enjoyed. Maybe it was a beautiful day. The body was healthy and the world was beautiful. And there was just a certain mood. They will not take note of it that it is transcendence beyond the three. However, if they take note of it, a runner can more easily come close to meditation than anyone else. If one takes note of this during the moments of lovemaking, one can come very close to meditation, very close to orgasm. But then we think that we are operating in a better way. That's why it is happening. And that is why people go on missing it. But these moments come every time that the interacts. Jogging too can be of immense help. So to swim can be of immense help. All these things have to be transformed into meditation. Only then life will become a synergistic harmony. Consciousness is energy. Only this much for this morning on this meditation. For some time there was a topic in my mind which was not action line, but yesterday I thought, India, my love, my being, my presence. India, my love, my being, my presence. A word which will soon be available. Probably by the first week of August might be meeting out. Only this much for this morning. Take care and do have a blessed day.